So, Lord Krishna, he descends yada yada hi dharma sugyani bhavuti, just to establish the real purpose of life. When man forgets the real purpose of life, the mission of human form of life, then it is called dharmasya glani, disturbance of the occupation of human being. So, in that circumstances, out of many, many human beings who awakens, one who awakens the spirit of understanding his position, for him this Bhagavad Gita is spoken. We are just like swallowed by the tigress of nisans, and Lord being causelessly merciful upon the living entities, especially for the human being, he spoke Bhagavad Gita, making his friend Arjuna as the student. Arjuna was certainly being an associate of Lord Krishna. He was above all ignorance, but still Arjuna was put into ignorance in the battlefield of Kurukshetra just to question about the problems of life to the Supreme Lord, so that the Lord can explain them for the benefit of future generation of human beings, to chalk out the plan of his life and act in that way, so that his life, his mission of human life can be perfect. So in this Bhagavad Gita, the subject matter is comprehending five different truths. The first truth is what is God. It is the preliminary study of the science of God. So that science of God is explained here. Next, the constitutional position of the living entities, jiva, Ishara and Jiva. The Lord, the Supreme Lord, is called Ishara. Ishara means controller. And Jiva, the living entities, and the Jivas, the living entities, they are not Ishara or the controller. They are controlled artificially. If I say that I am not controlled, I am free, this is not the sign of a sane man. A living being is controlled in every respect. At least in his conditioned life, he is controlled. So, in this Bhagavad Gita, the subject matter comprehends about the Ishara, the supreme controller and about the controlled living entities and prakriti, the nature, the material nature, and next the time, duration of existence of the whole universe, or this manifestation of the material nature, and the duration of time, or the eternal time, and karma. Karma means activity. Everything, the whole universe, whole manifestation, cosmic manifestation, is full of different activities. The living being, especially, they are all engaged in different activities. So we have to study from the Bhagavad Gita, Ishara, what is God, Jiva, what are these living entities, and Prakriti, what is this cosmic manifestation, and how it is controlled by time, and what are these activities. Now, out of these five subject matter, in the Bhagavad Gita, it is established that the Supreme Godhead, or Krishna, or Brahma, or Paramatma, you may call whatever you like, but the Supreme Controller, there is a Supreme Controller. So, the Supreme Controller is the greatest of all. And the living beings, they are in quality like the Supreme Controller. Just like the Supreme Controller, the Lord, He has control over the universal affairs, over the material nature, how it will be explained in the later chapters of Bhagavad Gita, that this material nature is not independent. She is acting under the direction of the Supreme Lord. Mayadhyakshena prakriti suyate sacharacharam. This material nature is working under my direction, mayadhyakshena, under my superintendence.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama.